Sundaland, the geologic history of Southeast Asia's forgotten land. Sundaland, also known as the Sunda Shelf, is a vast region of Southeast Asia that includes the Malay Peninsula, Indonesia, Borneo, and the Philippines. This landmass was once connected to the Asian mainland and Australia, forming a supercontinent known as Sundaland. Today, Sundaland is a complex and diverse region with a rich geological history that has shaped its landscapes and ecosystems. The formation of Sundaland. Sundaland's geologic history began about 500 million years ago, during the Cambrian period, when it was part of the Gondwana supercontinent. Over the next 400 million years, Gondwana broke up, and the landmass that would become Sundaland began to separate from Antarctica and drift northward. By the late Jurassic period, Sundaland had collided with the Asian mainland, forming a land bridge between Asia and Australia. This land bridge allowed plants and animals to migrate between the two continents and played a significant role in the evolution of the region's biodiversity. The tectonic evolution of Sundaland. Sundaland's geology is shaped by the movement of tectonic plates, which has caused the region to undergo a series of uplifts, subsidence, and volcanic eruptions. The region is situated at the intersection of several major tectonic plates, including the Eurasian plate, the Indo-Australian plate, and the Philippine Sea plate. These plates are in constant motion, causing earthquakes and volcanic activity throughout the region. One of the most significant events in Sundaland's geologic history was the collision between the Indian plate and the Eurasian plate, which began about 50 million years ago. This collision caused the formation of the Himalayan mountains and the uplift of the Tibetan plateau. It also caused the deformation of the rocks that make up Sundaland, creating folds and faults that are still visible today. The geological features of Sundaland. Sundaland's geology has created a diverse range of landscapes, from rugged mountain ranges to lush tropical forests and coral reefs. The region is home to some of the world's most active volcanoes, including Mount Merapi in Indonesia and Mount Mayon in the Philippines. These volcanoes have shaped the region's geology, creating rich soils that support agriculture and fertile fishing grounds. The region is also known for its extensive limestone formations, which are the result of ancient coral reefs that have been uplifted by tectonic forces. These formations can be seen in the limestone cliffs and karst landscapes of Borneo and the Philippines. Ecosystems of Sundaland. Sundaland's diverse ecosystems range from tropical rainforests and mangrove forests to coral reefs and highland forests. These ecosystems support a wide range of species, including mammals, birds, reptiles, amphibians, and invertebrates, many of which are found nowhere else on Earth. Tropical rainforests are one of the most iconic ecosystems of Sundaland, covering large portions of Indonesia and Malaysia. These forests are home to a diverse range of flora and fauna, including orangutans, tigers, elephants, and many species of birds and reptiles. Mangrove forests are another important ecosystem of Sundaland, found in coastal areas throughout the region. These forests are vital for protecting shorelines from erosion and storm surges, and they provide habitat for many species of fish, crustaceans, and mollusks. Coral reefs are also a critical ecosystem of Sundaland, providing habitat for a vast array of marine species, including fish, turtles, and sharks. These reefs are under threat from human activities, such as overfishing, pollution, and climate change, which can cause coral bleaching and death. Biodiversity of Sundaland. Sundaland is home to a remarkable diversity of species, with many unique and endemic taxa found nowhere else on Earth. The region is home to over 25,000 plant species, more than 500 species of mammals, over 1,500 species of birds, and countless species of reptiles, amphibians, and invertebrates. One of the most iconic species of Sundaland is the orangutan, found only in Indonesia and Malaysia. These great apes are among the most intelligent and charismatic animals on Earth, and they play a vital role in maintaining the health of the rainforest ecosystem. Other notable species of Sundaland include the Sumatran tiger, the Javan rhinoceros, the Bornean elephant, and the Komodo dragon. Many of these species are endangered or critically endangered due to habitat loss, poaching, and other human activities. The earliest evidence of human habitation in Sundaland dates back to at least 40,000 years ago, when hunter-gatherer communities lived in the region. These early humans relied on hunting, fishing, and gathering for their subsistence, and they left behind tools and artifacts that provide insight into their way of life. Around 5,000 years ago, The Neolithic Revolution brought significant changes to Sundaland, as humans began to practice agriculture and animal husbandry. This led to the development of more complex societies, with the establishment of permanent settlements and the emergence of early states and kingdoms. The classical era of Sundaland's history is characterized by the rise of powerful empires and trading networks. The Sriwijaya Empire, based in Sumatra, dominated much of the region from the 7th to the 13th centuries, controlling trade routes and spreading Buddhism and Hinduism. Another significant empire of this era was the Majapahit Empire, based in Java, which flourished in the 14th and 15th centuries. The Majapahit Empire was known for its powerful navy and its patronage of art, literature, and culture. In the 16th century, European colonial powers began to establish a presence in Sundaland, with the Portuguese, Dutch, and British vying for control of the region's resources and trade routes. The Dutch eventually emerged as the dominant colonial power, with control over much of Indonesia and parts of Malaysia. Colonial rule had a significant impact on Sundaland's history, as it led to the forced labor and exploitation of local populations, the establishment of plantation economies, and the suppression of local cultures and languages. In the aftermath of World War II, many of Sundaland's countries gained independence from their colonial rulers, leading to a period of political and social change. This era was marked by the rise of nationalism, the formation of new states, and the struggle for economic development and social justice. Despite the challenges of the post-colonial era, Sundaland's countries have made significant progress in recent decades, with economic growth, social development, and cultural revival. Today, Sundaland is a dynamic and diverse region, with a rich and complex history that continues to shape its present and future. Southeast Asia is a region that is rich in cultural diversity. It is home to over 600 million people and comprises 11 countries, each with its unique cultural traditions, customs, and beliefs. From Indonesia to the Philippines, Vietnam to Thailand, the region's cultural tapestry is woven with threads from a variety of ethnic groups, religions, and historical influences. One of the defining characteristics of Southeast Asia is its ethnic diversity. The region is home to over 2,000 ethnic groups, each with its unique language, customs, and traditions. Some of the largest ethnic groups in Southeast Asia include the Javanese, Sundanese, and Malays in Indonesia, the Vietnamese, Khmer, and Hmong in Vietnam, and the Thais, Lao, and Karen in Thailand.